Welcome to DIY Automotive School with my friend Pete and Minnie, the body shop girl. It's everything you need to know about cars and more.
We went ahead and installed the engine back into the vehicle, and basically the way that you install the engine back into the vehicle is in reverse. That means you jack the engine back up in there, you line up your pilot shaft, move it into the engine compartment and transmission where they sandwich together, and make sure that your pilot shaft lines up with your pressure plate. And one thing about installing your engine, what you'll want to do is put your car in gear and have somebody rock the wheel back and forth while you're pushing your engine into the vehicle. And what that's going to do, that's going to help line that pilot shaft up into the clutch plate. But this is basically what we did. We bought a used engine. This is the engine that came out of the car. This is the engine we bought. That's a used engine. We gave $500 for this engine. It's a very, very good engine. It's a strong engine. The person that we bought this engine from upgraded to a more powerful big engine, so we went ahead and bought that engine. But you can see that here's the engine that we pulled out. Now, these are the studs. These studs that we're looking at right here, these are your bottom bolts that was hard to get to. But this is the one right here that's really the pain in the ass. If you remember looking up into the engine and I was using a socket and a ratchet and an extension, that this one right here is the pain in the ass one. This is where our starter bolt would be, where we would come up from behind the engine on the passenger side, and then we'd get it from right there. So this was an all-day job putting this engine back together because I did a little swapping out. If you notice, we didn't use that fan shroud. We went back with the one that was originally in it. And then, of course, I cleaned it up. And I went ahead and used our carburetor versus the carburetor that came with the motor. And here's a little tech tip right here. This carburetor here is actually made by Empey. You don't want to buy one of these empty carburetors, they're junk. Try to stick with a Solex or a Borosol, Borosol or whatever it's called, the one made in South America or wherever the fuck, Brazil, there it is, Brazilian. The empty carburetor, in my opinion, the empty replacement carburetor is trash. So we'll be giving that back to Doug when we go over to Doug's and give him back this as a core job for buying this engine right here. The only other thing I got to do is go ahead and install my header back into the engine. You can see where it goes right here. But the reason I haven't done that yet, because I'm debating whether I ought to go ahead and just buy a brand new header for that header and muffler, since that one's old and rotted and it's kind of rusty looking and nasty. So we'll probably go ahead and buy a brand new one of those. Now, the reason I didn't go through the procedure of actually jacking the motor up into the vehicle is because we would have been watching a repeat of actually taking it out. Once again, all you got to remember is do everything in reverse of what you did when you pulled the motor out of the car. That means once the motor's in, just start by putting the bolt, the last bolt in that you took out, and work your way down. The wires are very, very easy to understand. There's only three wires that you disconnect. You got the generator slash alternator wires, and then you got two wires on your coil. You got a fuel line that you got to reconnect, and then of course you got the fuel cable that you got to put back through the fan shroud. Once you pull it out, you got to put it back in there, and then of course hook that up, and then your heater boxes. It's a very, very simple job, very, very simplicated job, a job that you know how to do. I'm sorry that we didn't go through procedures of putting it back in the car, because, I mean, it's pretty much a cut and dry situation. You know, you got your four bolts and your miscellaneous stuff, and you're done with it. This is Pete, my friend Pete, your friend Pete. I hope that you learned something from this. It was an all-day fucking job doing this. I'm tired. I'm going home. And happy Volkswagen. And happy Volkswagen. And happy Volkswagening down the road in your Beetle, Bug, Bus, Karmann, Ghia, whatever you're going to work on. It's all the same. It's a done deal. I got to go. Take it easy. We'll see you later.
Thanks for watching DIY Automotive School. Classes don't stop till you know everything.